Hi guys, today we can see some important characteristics of kingdom fungi. Fungi, they are placed in a separate kingdom, that is kingdom fungi. Fungi, they are eukaryotic organisms. They are unicellular or multicellular forms. They are chemoorganotrophs. They are not plants. They lack chlorophyll, so they are non-photosynthetic and they can reproduce either sexually or asexually. They produce spores. They can produce sexual or asexual spores. They may be saprophytes, commensals or parasites. Decomposers are the recyclers of nutrients. They help in recycling the nutrients in the environment. Some of them are parasites. They may be either internal or external parasites. Some can act as predators feeding on roundworms. Size varies from unicellular yeast to large puffballs. They can grow in warm and moist environment. Some are edible while others are poisonous, for example, mushrooms. There are mainly two types of fungi, unicellular yeast and multicellular filamentous fungi. First, we can see the characteristics of molds. These molds are multicellular filamentous forms and the body of fungi is called thallus. Thallus has two parts, mycelium and spores. That is the body of fungus, it is called thallus, and the thallus, it is formed of two parts, mycelium and spores. Thallus may be of different types, homothallic fungi, heterothallic fungi, eucarpic, holocarpic, etc. are the some important types of thallus or thalli. Hyphae is the structural unit of mycelium, that is mycelium is formed by a tangled mass of hyphae. Homothallic fungi, they are self-fertile, that is sexual reproduction is taking place within the thallus. That is within the single thallus, we can see sexual reproduction is taking place. So it is called self-fertile, such type of thallus, it is called homothallus and the fungus is called homothallic fungus. Heterothallic fungi, they are not self-fertile. Here, for fertilization or for sexual reproduction to occur, two compatible thallae are required. Such type of thallae or such type of fungus bearing such thallus are called heterothallic fungus. That is, for sexual reproduction to occur, two compatible thallae are necessary. Then, thallus may be eucarpic or holocarpic. Eucarpic means the thallus is differentiated into a vegetative and a reproductive part. That is, the thallus has both vegetative and reproductive part. Example, pythium. And if the thallus is not differentiated into a vegetative and reproductive part, it is called holocarpic thallus. Example is yeast. Here, after a phase of vegetative growth, the thallus gets converted into a reproductive structure. So, the thallus is not differentiated into a vegetative or reproductive part. Here, we can see at first a vegetative phase. After that vegetative phase, the thallus itself gets converted into reproductive structures. Such type of thallus are called holocarpic thallus. Example, yeast. Next, coming to fungal hyphae. Mycelium, it is formed of a tangled mass of hyphae. Hyphal wall or the hyphal cell wall, it is mainly composed of chitin. And the chitin is the structural foundation of hyphal cell wall. We can also see hemicellulose, mannan, glucan, polypeptides, etc. But the main structural foundation of hyphal cell wall is by chitin. Biosynthesis of chitin, it is controlled by chitin synthase. It's an enzyme and it is stored in a membrane-bound packet called chitosomes. That is, chitin synthase, it is present inside chitosomes and the chitosomes are present in the cytosol of the cytoplasm. Cytoplasmic membrane of the hyphal cell is called plasmalemma. It contains glycoproteins, lipids and ergosterol. Cytosol or the cytoplasm is very complex. It contains nucleus, nuclear membrane, mitochondria, ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi body, and other cytoplasmic organelles that of eukaryotic cells. And we can see a true nucleolus rich in RNA. Each hypha is 5 to 10 micrometers in diameter, and the hypha, it has a hyphal wall, and this hyphal wall, it encloses a hyphal lumen or cavity, and this hyphal lumen, it is filled with protoplasm. Here we can see the hyphal wall is mainly made of chitin, and this is the hypha. Here we can see the hyphal wall, and the hyphal wall, it encloses a lumen, and the lumen it is filled with protoplasm. And inside the lumen or inside the cytoplasm or in the cytoplasm, we can see almost all eukaryotic cell organelles. And one important speciality of hypha is hypha may be septate or aseptate. This is the diagram of a septate hypha, and this is the septum. And the septum, it is incomplete, so that we can see protoplasmic movement. And the hypha may be or hypha may be uninucleate or multinucleate. That is, the hyphal cells, it may contain a single nucleus or more than one nuclei. And the hypha may be branched or unbranched. Therefore, hypha may be septate or aseptate, uninucleate or multinucleate, branched or unbranched. Multinucleate condition is called cenocytic condition. You have already studied cenocytic condition or multinucleate condition in your previous classes. And this is a diagrammatic representation of hypha. And this is a septate hypha, and this is the cenocytic hypha. Septate hypha means here the hyphal cells, here we can see septum formation. This is a septum, and a single nucleus is present. So it is septate, uninucleate, branched hypha. Here we can see there is no septum, so we can see multinucleated condition. Therefore, this is aseptate, branched, cenocytic hypha. New hypha, it is generally arising from a spore. The spores germinate to form germ tube, and from the germ tube, that is germ tube elongates to form hypha. Young hypha, they form a centripetal invagination of the cell wall. That is, the cell wall at first get invaginated, followed that the plasma lemma constricts or it grows inwards to form an incomplete septum. The septum has a central pore allowing the protoplasmic streaming. Here we can see this is the hyphal growth from the spore. This is a spore. The spore germinates to form a germ tube, and this germ tube elongates to form hypha. This is the hypha, it forms a complete mass and this is the mycelium. Here we can see this is the germ tube. This is microscopic electron micrograph of the spore germinating to form this germ tube first. Here we can see septum formation, that is, this is the hypha, hyphal wall, hyphal plasma membrane. This is the hyphal lumen filled with the organelles. And here we can see at first the cell wall get invaginated, and this is followed by invagination of plasma lemma to form the septum, and the septum is incomplete with the central pore, so that we can see the movement of protoplasm. Next we can see some points about septum. Septa are of two types, normal septum and doliopore septum. Normal septum, it has a central pore. Doliopore septum, it is special and it is seen in basidiomycetes. Basidiomycetes means mushrooms, they are coming under basidiomycetes. The septum around the central pore, it is swollen and is capped by a membrane called parenchyma. This is a diagrammatic representation. This is normal septum. Here we can see a simple pore. This is the protoplasmic membrane septum. Then next we can see this is the doliopore septum. Here we can see a swelling. At the septum region we can see a swollen portion, and this is the doliopore. And this septum, it is covered by a pore cap called parenchyma. Okay, so this is a special type of septum present in basidiomycetes. Here we can see this is the septa. Here the septum, the tip is swollen and is covered by parenchyma. Molds also have some vegetative structures in addition to these structures. But these vegetative structures, they have no reproductive value, and these structures can be used in diagnosis or for differentiating various clinically important fungus. Similarly, they also have some mycelial modifications, and these mycelial modifications, for example, rhizoids, rhizomorph, sclerotium, you have already heard about these terms, and these are all vegetative modifications of the mycelium seen in molds, and they have specific functions. We can see the vegetative structures and the mycelial modifications in the next class. Hope you all understand the session. Thank you. Have a nice day.